So Carol said it, the new drug is a version of MDMA. It's also known as ecstasy. What else do we know about who's making it and what it could do for these people with this affliction?
Yeah, I mean, this drug has been researched for quite a while now. It was formerly known as MAPS, and now it's known as Lykos Therapeutics, the company that's bringing it up. And yeah, there's been a lot of excitement over it, and they've just run into a little more controversy as we get closer to the date of people questioning, hey, how do you actually run a clinical trial and have this placebo group, a control group, when you kind of know
it's like obvious if you've taken ecstasy or not, right? I suppose.
Well, I love there's a quote in there about everything about this is unprecedented. This is from the chair of the Council on Research at the American Psychiatric Association, which makes me wonder, so what is going on probably at this panel? What are the main issues? What are the concerns? Who's going to be heard from? What are going to be kind of the voices heard on this?
Well, today the FDA is looking at this and is going to make a vote, which is seen as influential, but it won't be till August that they make a final decision, keep in mind. But the things that have come up so far are everything from, you know, are these people being maybe unduly sort of influenced by the therapists? Because don't forget, this isn't just MDMA. It comes with psychedelic-assisted talk therapy of a kind we've never seen before.
Right.
And there are a lot of questions being raised about, were negative events reported as part of the trials? You know, how do we meet that gold standard of review when people know that they're in the placebo group?
Can you talk a little bit about what's at stake here? Because PTSD is debilitating for so many people, and there aren't a lot of treatments out there that have been proven to work.
That's right. Yeah, they say there are 13 million people suffering from PTSD. Veterans are a huge segment of that, and there is so much momentum to try and find a solution for these people. I mean, the statistics about suicides and things are alarming. I think that this is not just something that will affect this particular version of MDMA from Lykos, but this could be sort of a bellwether for the entire psychedelics industry, because it's really the first time the FDA is reviewing something like this.